Victory, victory, baby. You can call me Victory. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Sunso Life. So first time stopping by, definitely welcome. Make sure you subscribe down here and turn on the notification bell. It lets you know every time I drop a new video. You guys, I have done the review of Man of God too many times and something always comes up. I currently have one up on my channel, but I did not like the quality. This one is the one, and it took me a long time to set up. So make sure you share this video as you're watching it, please, please, and thank you. I felt like the Man of God had to be reviewed by someone, me. Today's video is going to be about the Man of God. It's a Nollywood movie on Netflix. Go check it out, please. Let me know what you think. If you've seen it, leave me a comment in the comment section. Let me know what your thoughts are. Let me know if you liked the movie, if it was good. If it wasn't, let me know what your thoughts are. Personally, I think that the movie was fantastic. I love the role that Aka played in the movie. Now, this movie is kind of centered around the prodigal son. If you know about the prodigal son in history, it's about a child who had everything at his fingertips but decided to go in search of greener pastures by himself and without the umbrella of his parents, or without like his parents monitoring him or telling him what to do. It just felt like he had to be his own man, and yeah, he did that. He left his home when he and his parents had a fight, and he felt like, okay, his parents were being hostile to him, especially his dad, who was a pastor. And I feel like this is very common in African households where your father is like of noble status and they want things to go a certain way, but then there's you who's a rebel and you always want to do things your own way. He wanted to do things his own way, and then his father was always beating him, which was, I felt like that beating was too much. But yeah, and he left home and it was like, I will never come back again. And it was very sad to see that he neglected his mom, even though his mom always sent messages to him. It kind of felt like it felt like when you're protesting against a group of people, you don't want to lean onto one side and then avoid the other side. So it's not like you're picking and choosing what side to go with. It just means that you're protesting against the body as a whole. That's why I think about the movie. This movie was about a car who left the home and then he went to school, which was in UNILAG, by the way. He went to school, and UNILAG is University of Lagos, if anybody does not know that. I feel like I've seen UNILAG in a lot of movies that I already know what it looks like. Even before I step in, I already know exactly, like, this is UNILAG. I was in school for a bit, and then he had this friend Rex, who was DSF. Dokar Shalafap in the movie, and I feel like she did an amazing role in the movie. And she was his friend, and they would go for shows together, and then they would do businesses together, try to find money together, and they would also like sleep together. It was kind of like they were together, but they were not together. I would call it friends with benefits. There's that friend who's there for you and would do anything for you, but they were not really an item. And then he liked Joy, who was this fresh meat, you know, very light skin girl. She was almost white, and I feel like she was so pure. She was like genuine. She was sister girl, always going to church, you know, the kind of girl that every man wants, basically. And she was really good. And then he fell in love with her, and he felt like, okay, you know, this is my love interest, and I'm going to do everything within my power to like make it work. I feel like a lot of men do this, where if they see a woman who is maybe should I say above their status, or someone that's just like higher in rank, I don't know how to place it, but just someone that is like, they know that this person is too good to be in my level, I don't know how to place it, but you know what I mean. I mean, like, someone that is like, that person's way above here, you just want to like do anything to keep that person. I feel like that's what he was doing. And every time his friend Teju, who invited him to church, to go to church, he would never go to church. But the minute he knew about Joy, he was like, oh, what church? I'm going to be there. And then he wanted to, I feel like Joy could have bettered his life, because he would have been a fantastic person with somebody like that. Men would change at the snap of a finger for somebody that they really, really like. So the story centered around him sharing a room with Rex, and then from Rex he fell in love with Joy, and then he was also friends with Teju. He eventually like got married to Teju. I like that the movie was not predictable, because to me I felt like it was going to end up with Joy, because him and Joy, they had very good chemistry. It felt like it was staying around her, and she always like made him happy and stuff. But Joy left and she got married, and I feel like the story was very, very believable, regardless of how, like, I like the fact that it wasn't centered around two people the whole time. And usually that's what Nollywood movies is always all about. It's like two people and you know them from the beginning, blah, 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 all the way to the end. But I like the fact that the movie was very diverse. It wasn't like centered around two people the whole time. And can we also talk about the houses they used in the movie? The houses were gigantic. They were so massive and very, very beautiful. Nigerians have money. Like, anybody who lives in Nigeria, they're rich. Like, don't let anybody tell you anything different. The costumes were amazing. Aka played the role of a singer in Shango. He played the role of a singer in Fela's Shrine. Like, it was just like imitating Fela, the great Fela, if you know Fela. And he sang. It was very, very believable. The dancing, it was very energetic. Even if the songs were played in the background, he really did a lot of job into bringing it to light, and it felt very, very real. It was very believable. Like, they put a lot of energy into that. And Rex also was a backup singer in Fela's Shrine. I feel like I need to go there once. But it was really, really, it was really believable, and I loved the role that they played. Aka was the prodigal son, it was the pastor, it was the artist, and he did every role fantastically well. For someone who has not really played a big lead before, I feel like this was really, really good. I like the fact that they used someone new to play the lead role. Aka has been an actor and like a good boy, quote unquote. I follow him on YouTube. He has a YouTube channel where he talks about concerning things in Nigeria. And I love the fact that they gave him a role of like a bad boy, and then all of a sudden he became this pastor, quote unquote. Is something that they do where people go into the pastoring business. I call it the pastoring business because he woke up one day and he told his wife that God called me, and I feel like this is what I should do.
Teju, I just heard from God.
What?
I just heard from God. He called my name 3 times. Samuel, Samuel, Samuel. Told me to get into ministry, just like my father.
Even though his wife had been pestering him into being something that is not. Women, please, this movie teaches you to do not try to shape a man into something that is not. Like, do not try to pick a bad boy and then hope that one day he'll be a good boy. Like, you can see somebody that drinks, smokes, womanizes, does a lot of things that you do not like, and then you now marry him and you're like, oh, he's going to change, I know that God's going to touch his heart. And then one day, miraculously, it wasn't as if there are steps that build up to a certain stage in your life. You don't just wake up one morning and then you're like, oh, God called me. You probably would have changed your habits. Like, there are a lot of things that you'd have stopped doing, or a lot of things that you just started doing. He wasn't doing anything, just woke up one day and said God called him. And then that's how he found himself in pastoring business. I call it pastoring business because it's what a lot of people do, where they feel like there are no jobs out there and being a pastor would save you or would make you money, basically. Like, you just have to go to church and, you know, be believable. Then people would just donate money and then you get money. And a lot of people do this these days. Do I blame them? No. I feel like Samuel played the role very well. He kind of neglected his mom, which is very sad for me, because I feel like our moms go through a lot and they shouldn't have to suffer for the things that our dads do. What am I talking about? I'm talking as if I'm a family member of his. I'm not. But I feel like women sometimes suffer, even though, like, you've labored for the child, you've done a lot of things, you try to put the child in the right path and everything, and then things still don't turn out the way you want, and then you still have to suffer for it. It was very sad to see. And then when his mother died, his brother came and he felt really bad. Like, oh, you know, I feel like it's like a place of regret where you feel like you could have done a lot of things differently. You could have done a lot of things better. But he did not do anything of such. He just was looking out for himself. He wanted to see, like, how can I make it in life? How can I do this? And then towards the end of the movie, he went back to Rekia. who kind of introduced him to doing drugs, but he didn't even do the drugs yet, and it was caught because he kind of neglected his wife and she found everything. That's why they say, like, do not offend somebody who has all your life at their fingertips. Like, they have all your life in one hand. Try not to offend people like that. Like, you can always break up. You can always tell your partner that, oh, I'm not really interested in this anymore, without making it go ugly. Like, that's just what I think. I feel like relationships scatter every day. It doesn't have to be ugly. It doesn't have to be bad. It doesn't have to be something that everybody is now regretting that they were in this situation in the first place. You can just say, oh, I don't think this is working for me anymore. And, you know, instead of, like, he wanted to elope. He was planning to leave to Canada. He already got his documents and he left his wife. And, you know, of course, she felt bad. And when she confronted him, instead of him to, like, be apologetic about it, it was still making him out, and we're like, oh yes, I'm going to do that, and then I'm leaving, blah, blah, blah. And she's like, oh, you are leaving, I will show you Pepe. Once a woman says, I'll show you Pepe, I mean, she didn't say that directly, but, like, yeah, she reported him to the police that he was into drug trafficking and human trafficking, and he didn't even know anything about it. But yeah, he was arrested, was thrown in jail, and then I love the fact that he came back home, which is kind of like the prodigal son story. He came back home to his father after years and years and years, and his father did not even second guess it. As soon as he saw him, he embraced him. And that's kind of like the love of a father to a child, or a love of a mother to a child, regardless of how horrible a child would be, regardless of how terrible, how disrespectful you've been to your parents in the past. Like, you would always be your parents' children. It teaches a lot of lessons. That's what I feel. It teaches a lot of lessons where it speaks that, it says that, like, do not think that your parents abandoned you. Like, even if they do not keep in contact with you for weeks and weeks on end, or even if you have big fights and whatever, you always have a home to go back to. You always have somewhere to call home, as long as your family lives there. Yeah, I feel like I said a lot of things that are those beneficial. Like, the movie teaches a lot of things. It teaches not to be greedy, and teaches you to, like, keep your friends close, and it also teaches you to remember your family regardless of how high you might be and then how low you might get. Like, family is still family regardless. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment down below, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm enjoying this review so far. Let me know if you've seen my previous review. Give me a thumbs up, and if you've not, go check it out. Leave me a comment in the comment section. Let me know your thoughts, and see you in the next one. Make sure you subscribe. Bye.